everybody, live on 2K Sports alongside Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. I'm Kevin Hart. Look at the 76ers starting group. And for Golden State.
You know, most great teams are really built around one or two stars and then some role players surrounding that core. But the Sixers are different. They don't have a superstar. So they've played the last few years with a group of young guys who are athletic, who play together, who defend, and they try to get out and run. So for the most part, it's been pretty successful. But again, so tough to win in this league at a high level without a star.
So Golden State will get the first possession. Number 10, got it from 16 feet.
And there are a group of teams that have found success, Steve, like that. You know, you can point at teams like, say, Memphis and the Indiana Pacers, Clark, you know them. And certainly, Clark, the 76ers along that same vein.
You know, Kevin, as Steve said, it's hard to win without a star, and you wonder if Philly will eventually shake things up to bring somebody in of that level. But I'm not quite sold on the fact that you can't do it at a high level with really good cohesive players. And much like the Sixers, Grizzlies, Pacers, those teams have good young players, and I think they can be championship contenders if they keep developing.
They set the screen off the mark with the little step back, Johnny. Warriors on D, and now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
I was able to catch up with the head coach of the 76ers. He told me that he really wants his team to be aggressive on the defensive end of the floor. He feels that they'll have a chance of creating a lot of easy layups if they pressure their guards and force some turnovers in the open floor, something no coach wants to see on the other end, guys.
Thank you very much, Doris. The defensive strategy guys being heavily enforced by the coaching staff.
And that's in large part because of the talent they have on that side of the ball. A lot of length, speed, quick hands. They've got a lot of ability on that side of the floor.
Well, when you've got the horses, you've got to ride them and let them run. And defensively, they've definitely got some horses.
And it's the Warriors with the ball. Number 7. Number 10. Good on the baseline, Jay. First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone. Can't hit.
Boy, for my taste, he's far too inconsistent with that shot. I mean, he's got to make those if he's going to take his game to the next level.
Tries from 16, and the shot is good. 76ers have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. Six on the shot clock. Number 14. And that one's good. He has 5. The Warriors have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Number 16. It's hauled in by the 76ers. And here on the first, approaching 3 minutes played. Good on the shot.
Love the finish there. Not much defense, though.
The Warriors trail. Shot clock at 6. Number 8 misses the 3. There's the bucket. Good. Just over 3.5 minutes gone here in the first.
Clark some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Number 16, count the bucket.
You know, the defense has to prevent the ball from getting down into that area if they're going to be successful, guys.
They set the pick.
Number 15, again, Philadelphia.
That's a tough shot down there, but I love how he kept his eye on the rim and dropped it in.
Number 11. And that one's good.
He is always so in control, guys. Even when he's going hard to the hoop, very skilled finisher.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here.
You know, the interesting story a year ago with Golden State was promises season ticket holders that they would make the playoffs. And, you know, I thought it went overboard a little bit because the Warriors team just wasn't quite talented enough to fulfill that promise. And anytime you put yourself out on a limb like that, it can be dangerous. You're now in a vulnerable spot.
Number 14, again, Philadelphia. And to be fair, the Warriors were in a position at one point where they had a chance at the playoffs. I'm going back some time now, but the injuries just put them out of contention.
Yeah, it really did. And although it derailed them a bit, it showed the value of depth, something the Warriors wanted to address this offseason. And they still have playoff ambitions because of that.
Down low, shot is blocked. To the inside. And that one's good. He's got 9.
Something has to change, guys. That's 10 straight points coming in the paint against this team.
Well, they got to collapse in there, and everybody's got to be conscious of it. It's a team effort in protecting the paint. Control the ball, and then everybody's got to get in there and keep the defense locked down.
And here are the Warriors now. The 76ers getting the bucket. And that one's good.
First and foremost, for me, it's his three-point shooting that's the most entertaining. Every trip down, he is a threat to bury one from almost anywhere on the floor.
Also, guys, so often we see him playing possum at the defensive end. And then all of a sudden, he springs into action, picks off a pass, and ignites the fast break.
They get it again. Shades. And their work on the board pays off with the second-chance points.
They are in attack mode right now. That's 10 straight points, guys, all coming inside the paint.
And Steve, if I'm them, I'd keep going right to the heart of that defense like they have been until they do something about it. If they don't offer resistance, take everything you can get in there.
Number 7. Good!
What a start it's been for them from the field in this game.
You know what? It's early, but if they can keep shooting at this rate, Steve, they'll run away with this thing.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here.
Philadelphia, by virtue of playing a number of games at home early in the season, really started hot last year, but then faded down the Eastern Conference ladder as the season wore on. A part of that was their difficulty in winning games on the road.
And the Warriors with a completely new 5 on the floor. And it's the Warriors with the ball. They trail by 7. Number 5. And again, no good by Golden State. You mentioned it, Clark. 76ers road play. They finished 16-17 there, which isn't bad, but it kept them down probably at that 8th seed in the Eastern Conference. And Steve, a few more wins, it would have changed a lot for them.
Well, as it was, though, it turned into a pretty good draw because they were actually able to play Chicago in the first round after Rose got injured. They won that round, took Boston to 7. So that 8th seed actually was kind of a charm for them.
And that one's good. The 76ers leading by 5. Passes it to Peterson. Back and down. Goes right up. And the layup is good.
carving them up inside there, Kevin. I mean, the defense has been vulnerable in there.
Yeah, that's three straight field goals in the paint area. That's really good offense.
And so here is Golden State. Number five. Gets the bucket.
It has been all offense here early.
It sure has been. I mean, both teams clicking, and it's been an entertaining game as well, guys.
And 101 left to play here in the first. Here's Peterson. Nice from the high post. Warriors trail by five. Here's Gardner. That's good.
And guys, 10 of their last 12 points coming in the paint.
Yeah, I like their aggressiveness on offense, but the question is, where's the defense? They've got to put up some resistance here.
You know, there have been rumblings, guys, that the Warriors are looking at a return to San Francisco, and maybe building a new stadium across the bay. But we'll see how that goes. That's a very difficult thing to do these days, to secure the finances necessary and the permits through the city. So we'll see what ends up happening. But either way, we know the Warriors will remain extremely popular in the Bay Area.
And I know they've been looking for a place to play in San Francisco. They had a chance to go play over where the Giants are. And they chose, Clark, their own spot down on Pier 3032. So in 2017, they will be in San Francisco.
That's right. Coming to the Bay, it's hard enough to find parking in San Francisco, much less a spot to put a stadium in.
Yeah, that's a low percentage shot right there.
Yeah, it sure is. I mean, he's got to be thinking out there a little better. Make the pass in that situation. Don't force a bad shot. Boy, a nice little trend developing here, fellas. I mean, that's eight of their last 10 from inside the paint.
Yeah, they're getting high percentage looks down there. Their offense is really clicking. I don't see why they wouldn't just continue to pound the ball inside.
Here's Shane. The shot from the low post is good. 6 points for him.
Exceptional play to take the bump and still get it up and down.
Yeah, way to stay with it and look to finish the play right there.
Number seven. And that one's good. Both teams trading buckets as we end the first quarter. 76ers lead by one. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. And off we go. A close game now starting the second quarter. What stands out to you guys from the 76ers in this one?
And that first quarter was all about pace, guys, because this club really got out into transition, and that's how they built this lead.
They like to play fast, and they're doing a nice job filling the lane.
So to begin the second quarter for the Philadelphia 76ers. Five to shoot. The fadeaway. Can't get it to go.
The fadeaway was the right shot there because it got his attempt away from the defender, but the touch was poor.
And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, over to you.
Well, Kevin, the Warriors ownership have some big plans, and those include a new waterfront arena in San Francisco's Embarcadero District starting in 2017. The new site, located south of the Bay Bridge on Piers 30 to 32, would have glass walls on three sides to overlook the incredible views. It would also mark the Warriors' return to San Francisco after having played in Oakland for the last 40 years. But the Warriors really are, quote, the Bay Area's team. And with the public transport options and the booming financial sector both near the site of the new arena, it certainly seems like a great location.
A lot of excitement around this Warriors franchise. A beautiful new arena can only help. And the 76ers with a completely new group now.
Well, his playmaking is off the charts, and the beauty of that, Kevin, is his teammates know that. So they're going to work hard to get open, knowing that if they do, he'll find them for an open look.
And something else he has on his resume are his ball skills. What a ball handler and dribbler. I mean, he looks like he was born with a basketball in his hands. It looks like it's part of his body.
Gone 2 of 3 from the field. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Shoots from the line. Another shot. And that's 2 points on the layup. He's got 13.
No question, they're trying to pound the ball inside. That's 5 straight hoops inside.
And if the D won't stop it, keep at it. I mean, those are the kind of looks you want all day long.
The Warriors making a switch here. And that one misses.
Well, the one thing about Philadelphia last year, guys, was they didn't have a star. So they really had more of an ensemble cast where 4 or 5 different players could beat you on any one given night. And that can be a problem, though, when the game slows down. And Philly found that out later on in the season when they kind of ran out of energy.
So it's the Warriors now after the Sixers pick up 2. At 6. Number 18. And off target as he starts the game 0-for-1. Back to what you said, Steve. It's these tough stretches where players go cold and things don't go your way. You know, Clark, that's when Philly needed a star to lead on.
And that's what seems to be the difference between the top teams and just the really good teams, Kevin. Having that go-to guy, and it doesn't have to be production, that's a big part of it, but leadership is really an aspect of that go-to guy as well, to be able to weather the storms when things aren't going as smoothly as you like. I think Philly still needs to be able to identify somebody to fill that role for.
And the 76ers call time here.
Boy, how about that scene a year ago when the Warriors decided to retire Chris Mullin's number, and the owner, the team owner, was actually presenting Mullin. He was booed during the ceremony. Very ugly scene and very disappointing from the fans, but you have to understand their frustration too. This is a team that has made the playoffs only once in the last couple of decades.
And for those of you just joining us, we're in the second quarter with about 3 minutes gone by. Number 7. Another miss by Philadelphia. Back to that moment you brought up, Steve. It was a tough scene to watch, and really it just seemed like an opportunity for the fans, I think, Clark, to vent more than anything else.
And Kevin, vent they did. If you're a fan base that has gone through what they have over the past 4 decades, you can empathize with that built-up frustration. Still, it was an unfortunate thing to have happen on what should have been Chris Mullin's night.
And Philadelphia has possession, following the score by Golden State.
Yeah, we're now starting to see them get some high percentage shots in the paint.
Yeah, that's 5 of their last 6 buckets inside the lane, so they're getting really high percentage looks down there.
So it's the Warriors now. Number 8, and another basket for Golden State. The 76ers trail by 4. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Number 16. Cannot hit. The Warriors go the other way with it. Puts up the baby hook. Number 16 gets it to go. And the Warriors lead by 6.
That's a nice play there. The more contributors this team can get, the better.
Oh, 76ers moving the ball around. Five on the clock. Swing against the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
You know, like a lot of teams that struggle in the NBA, Kevin, the Warriors just could not close out games in the fourth quarter. And that's a fairly common theme among teams that aren't near the top of the standings. There's so much talent in the NBA, but the best teams really clamp down in the last 5 minutes, and they know how to win.
And that one goes in, two from the line that time. Well, back to the Warriors, a lot of games ended with tough losses at the end of the fourth, but you could have expected that from such a young team.
Well, a team with a lot of rookies, Kevin, playing heavy minutes, and a first-year head coach and Mark Jackson as well. Not surprising that they played close games and came up short in a number of them.
Now the 76ers on the break. Lays it in off the breakaway. 8 points for him.
They continue to barrel their way inside, and when's the defense going to adjust?
Well, I'm asking the same question myself, partner. I mean, that's 8 points out of their last 10 coming inside. A tight game here, and neither team has been able to gain an upper hand on the backboards.
Well, both teams really getting after it inside. It's been an interesting battle.
And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Guys, after getting up close to 300 pounds a few seasons back, Kendrick Perkins has slimmed down quite a bit and still is one of the strongest players in the league. He said, in the past, I was used to eating whatever I wanted. I had to change up my diet, and I feel a ton better. It's just a sacrifice you have to do. You have to be honest with yourself and look yourself in the mirror and go from there. Guys?
All right, Doris, thanks.
And guys, even the spelt version of Perk can set some bone-jarring screens.
Off target with the free throw line, Jay. The 76ers trail by four. Number seven. It's blocked, and that one's good.
And his specialty is tracking down those great offensive rebounds that oftentimes he can put right back up for an easy deuce.
Steve, he is always on the prowl. I mean, you got to body him up early, or he'll stake out that prime real estate for those second shot opportunities.
And so here is Golden State. The 76ers getting the bucket. Number eight. No good from the wing. The 76ers have gone 6 of 13 so far from the field here in the second quarter. And it's all evened up.
Now they'll take as many of those high percentage shots as they can get, guys.
Warriors have gone 8 of 14 in the second quarter on field goal attempts. Now a timeout called by Golden State.
You know, he wants to tinker a little bit, and he's taking the time to do so right here.
Yeah, I think you're right. He just didn't like some of the things he saw out there, a bit uncomfortable, and wanted to talk it over.
Both teams will make substitutions. There's a minute 34 left in the first half of basketball. Three-pointer. No good. And the 76ers go the other way with it. Pushing it up. Number 14. And that is good. 11 points in the game.
This is not what they wanted to let happen. They're just getting pounded inside.
Yeah, they are, Steven. I mean, they're just not making life difficult at all for scorers in the paint. I mean, that's an area that you've got to protect with force and aggressiveness, and we haven't seen it.
Puts up the baby hook. Rebound by the 76ers. Here's Philadelphia. They've gone in a 10-2 run, not allowing much. Number five. This is the Jay off the hasty drop step. The Warriors trailing. 43 seconds left in the first half. And again, it's the Warriors missing.
Opportunity to go 2-for-1 here if they want it.
Steve, let's see if they go for it.
Six to shoot. Here's Seymour. No good with the wing jumper. The Warriors shooting it really well, 54% from the floor. Garden lays it in without an inch of room around him. He has five. Number 14. And no good trying to get that one. And that'll do it for the first half. Game time. And coming up after the break, it'll be Damon Bruce breaking down all the highlights from the first half of play.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
It's a lively Friday evening here at 2K Sports. Hopefully you're having a great time watching a little basketball tonight. Plenty of hustle from the Warriors. This is a disciplined team, and when it comes to boxing out, controlling the backboard with fundamental play, we've seen it so far. And on the other side, the 76ers are also putting up quality numbers. At every opportunity, they're pushing it on the break and looking to run it down the opponent's throat. And that's all we have for you here in the studio. Now let's send it on back to Kevin Harlan, Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke for the second half of play.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half. Good. 9 points in the game so far. Gone 80% from the field. 4 of 5 shooting. And for Philadelphia. Here's the screen. Number 10, kept alive, and Jen shot, that's good.
Real persistence on his part, stayed with the play and cashed in with the second chance points.
The 76ers shooting has just been outstanding tonight, 56% as a team in this game. And for Golden State, to the middle. Number 7, the shot is off. And Golden State will come the other way. So on the floor for Philadelphia. Number 7. Well-placed jumper from the free throw line. He's got 17.
Boy, he's been so cool out there. Composed, never rattled. I mean, a very steady contributor to the offense.
So it's Philadelphia now. A 2-point game. Picked his pocket. Number 11. Oh, that's blocked. Just over a minute and a half played here in the third. Off the pick. Goes back up. Warriors with the rebound.
This is not the start to the second half they wanted. Coming out shooting just 1 of 4.
Number 7. That's good. 19 points in the game.
You know, they're just getting hammered inside and really need to find a way to be tougher down there. They got to be physical. They got a man up in there.
I agree. I mean, you look at the points they're giving up, most of them seem to be coming inside the paint.
Timeout call, the 76ers.
Well, the 76ers didn't really make any drastic changes heading into last year, preferring to just let their core grow. And I thought that worked for the most part. You know, they really played well early in the season, but it was kind of disconcerting to see them fade the way they did late in the year.
So it's Philadelphia now. 76ers moving the ball around. Number 14. Misses the wing Jerry. Still, though, you know, a lot of teams faded toward the end, Steve, don't you think? And if you're the 76ers, you have to be pleased with, you know, Clark, how that core grew as they approached the end of the season.
Yeah, they know that they can have stretches where they can really compete with anybody in the East without really having to bring anybody in. The next step for them is to be able to maintain that level of play for the whole season and continue to get growth from their young players.
And so here is Philadelphia. The Warriors making the shot. Offensive rebound, gets the bucket. He's got 11.
Just too easy. They're getting whatever they want down there.
You said it, Steve. 5 straight field goals inside for him. The defense has to clamp down here.
And so it's Golden State with it. Just 4 points. That's all they've given up here in the second half. And the shot is good. And the Warriors lead by six.
I like it. He could have gone for the forced finish, but opted instead for kind of the nice, smooth finger roll. I like it.
And the shot is good.
Boy, I love the way they've been attacking inside, Kevin.
All right, guys, they're getting a lot of points in the painted area, not settling for outside shots, and I don't see any reason to change strategy here.
And the Warriors with possession here. Number 10. And another basket for Golden State.
Well, of the two teams offensively, they've been more oriented towards those mid-range shots.
Yeah, Steven, they're focused on getting open quality looks, whether it's from behind the arc or inside the arc. And right now, it's been more inside the arc.
And here are the 76ers now. The Warriors making the shot. Shot clock at six. Number 14. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. So it's both teams making substitutions here. And it's the Warriors' ball. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Shot clock at five. Number seven. Offensive rebound. Using his post moves to get the 2 points. The 76ers trail by eight. Number five. It's rebounded by Golden State.
You know, when the shot's not there for you, you just got to recognize it, move the ball on.
I think he had tunnel vision right there. His only thought was to shoot, no matter what else was going on.
Number seven, good on the 13-footer. And it's a 10-point Warrior lead.
What a quarter for him. And with this lead, I mean, they might as well just ride him the rest of the night.
And the 76ers call time here.
Well, good timeout, guys, because, you know, this has been a bad run for them. He's got to get his team back on the same page and executing well together.
Sometimes just getting the stop in the action can be enough to get a team back on track. There's something about that little pause in the intensity of the game that lets you refocus.
There's the pass to Peterson. They set the pick. Clock at six. Goes up to the stripe. That's good. He has six.
Well, he can squeeze himself into the box score every now and then.
Number five. Offline from the high post. The 76ers trail by eight. From the high post. And the rebound goes to the Warriors.
And they're struggling a little bit on the glass. They've got to pick up their physical play in the paint.
Yeah, it's about being tougher and more physical, just as you said, Steve. If they can do that better, they've got a chance to come back.
Doing a nice job of knocking down jump shots, aren't they?
Yeah, they are, Steve. I mean, their mid-range game has been formidable and right on task. I'm really picking this defense apart.
And so here is Philadelphia, trailing by 10. Puts one up from 19. No luck. And for the 76ers, they're shooting a troubling 38% in the third. Not the finest work of this offense. Number five. Tries again. Peterson. And it's good. Terrific work on the offensive glass to make that one work. 8 points for him. 1:37 left to play in the third. That's good. And the Warriors lead by 8.
Unbelievable shot there. He busted out the trick release and left the defender dazed and confused.
Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. To the paint, number 10. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in.
That's 4 of their last 5 buckets now coming in the paint area.
They're in attack mode right now, barreling in there with bad man intentions.
Timeout called, the Warriors. Both teams deciding to change it up. Eight seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Just 5 on the clock. Number 7. And the Warriors miss again. The 76ers trail by 6. Here's Shays, and the 76ers tack on 2 more.
It's been a great day for him from the field, but his team still trailing.
Warriors leading by 4. There's the screen. Inside, number 16. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in. He's got 6.
And did you see the pick there? Got him wide open all the way to the rim.
The third quarter comes to a close. Warriors ahead. They lead by 6. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Oracle Arena in Oakland, California. Fourth quarter getting going here. It's time for the Sprite Uncontainable Game. Doris Burke with the report. Hi, Doris.
Thank you, Kevin. Our uncontainable game in this one, the stretch by the Warriors. They came out of halftime completely rededicated to the defensive end, and that allowed them to gain this advantage. Definitely a game changer as they head to the fourth.
Okay, Doris, thanks. That scoring run, guys, was pretty key in this game so far, don't you think?
Yeah, very much so, Kevin. I mean, that was like a runaway train there for a while. No stopping them. That really blew the game open.
Well, you bet it did. I mean, when you've got one team in such terrific offensive rhythm and the other guys on their back feet, tentative, hesitant, it almost always leads to runs like that.
And for the 76ers. Here's Shays. Can't cash in from the high post. Warriors leading by 6. And for the Warriors. So the whistle blows on the shot and 2 free throws for the contact right there.
Yeah, the defender draped all over.
Pretty plain and simple. Got him good there.
Number 7. At the line for 2.
The first one falls. So both teams making some changes here. Good on both. The 76ers trail by 8. On the court for Philadelphia to start the fourth. Number 7. And not a good shot for him. They can get better looks than that. Baseline J, that's good. And the Warriors lead by 10. 60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
The 76ers again can't hit it. The Warriors shooting the ball really well in this game, 58%. Six on the shot clock. He tries for three. No good. The 76ers trail by 10. Here's Shays. A stupendous finish in traffic.
Well, and you love the way he searched for good shots all game long.
Warriors leading by 8. High post try, and the officials call over the back. A little too aggressive there.
Obviously, he's not afraid of physical play, but he still needs to play in control.
And he definitely wasn't in control that time. Everybody in the building knew it was an over-the-back call.
Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Clock at 6. Goes up on the high post. Another miss by Philadelphia.
Well, they're now +5 in the rebound category, really controlling the glass.
And rebounding is one of those non-glamour stats. I mean, it takes work and effort and tenacity and physicality. But when you look at the scoreboard, you can see the correlation.
And it's the 76ers with the ball. The Warriors making the shot. With one on the clock. Can't get it to go. And Golden State will go the other way with it. Look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Fires top of the key. Gets it to go. And it's a 12-point Warrior lead. The 76ers have gone just 1-6 in the field to start the fourth quarter. A bit of a slowdown for them right now. Number 15. Stolen away. An even 3-on-3 break. And the Warriors tack on 2 more.
Impressive play there. They have been really good offensively.
Piling up the points en route to this big lead, guys. I mean, they've been unstoppable.
And Philadelphia has possession. Misses the chippy right there.
And he's having all sorts of problems with his shot.
I'm not sure he even has a shot right now, Steve, to be quite honest. Not a reliable one anyway.
Some nice passing by Golden State. Gets it to go. And the Warriors lead by 16.
Showing no mercy. They are getting after them at both ends of the floor.
Continuing to add to the lead as the minutes tick away.
Philadelphia with the ball. Here's Seymour. Another miss by Philadelphia.
Well, they've built a big lead here so far, and a lot of it has to do with how well they've been rebounding.
Yeah, every time they make a stop, they're securing the rebound, and that's really allowed them to get out to this lead.
Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cottonmouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Just 5 to shoot. There's a screen. Number 15. And he can't stop this drought. Another miss. Tries from 16. Can't get it to go. And Philadelphia the other way now. Now the 76ers on the break. Number five gets it to go. Warriors leading by 16. Down to five on the shot clock. He's off from 17 feet. The 76ers trail by 16. High post shot. No luck.
Well, he's building a house with those bricks. I mean, one reason is he keeps trying to force it up when he's defended well. Move the ball. Share the sugar.
That is good.
He's flipped the script here in this half,
shooting a much higher percentage from the field.
Timeout called, the 76ers. And the 76ers making a change here. And for the 76ers, they're shooting well. They're at 45%. Shot clock at six. Goes up on the wing. And that's good for two. And it's the Warriors' ball. They're on a 16-6 run. Five on the clock. Number eight. A three-pointer off the mark. There's a minute 40 left here in the fourth quarter. Number 10. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession. The 76ers trail by 16. 1:24 left to play in the final quarter.
Well, you know, guys, we've talked before about all the advanced training methods these days. One of the newest ones I've been hearing about is called cryotherapy. The Mavericks were the first team to really make it popular. It's like taking an ice bath, but taking it way up a notch, or about 10 notches. They actually use liquid nitrogen. You get into the machine, and the air cools around the players to negative 185 degrees Fahrenheit. But it really keeps the players' bodies going and allows them to regenerate their energy quickly.
And here are the 76ers now, following the score by Golden State. 46 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Six to shoot. Number 15. And the basket good. And going back to that cold treatment, Steve, the player is really spoiled by it. It increases circulation, suppresses pain, and they say that after you get out, you just feel good.
Well, you know, players have always iced, Kevin, you know, whether it's icing your knees, your ankles, or whatever. But this thing, I think, takes this this treatment to a new level. And it's one of the reasons that you see guys like Steve Nash and Ray Allen and Dirk Nowitzki competing at such a high level later on in their careers. Guys just have more ways to take care of themselves these days, and it's apparent.
And so here is Golden State. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. The offensive rebound. So we see the Warriors taking the game here. Some days, Clark, everything goes right for a team, and it just did one of those games.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, these guys played a great all-around basketball game here.
For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. Now it's time to present our Jordan Player of the Game.